The Ice Hound is a new super troop coming to Clash of Clans. Let's tell you everything you need to know. Welcome back to the channel then, guys. I'm your host, Juno Sloth. Another sneak peek. We first discussed the invisibility spell on day one, the log launcher siege machine on day two, explained the super wizard yesterday, but today we introduce the Ice Hound. This is the super version of the Lava Hound. So I want to first go over how you unlock it, compare stats between the Ice Hound and the regular Lava Hound before going over the mechanics with gameplay and attack strategies. But as ever, I have video chapters so you can skip ahead to any section you wish or review them. In order to unlock the Ice Hound, you need to be a Town Hall 12 and have your Lava Hound to level 5 in the laboratory. This is all you will see if you do not meet the requirements. However, when you do, these are the stats of the level 5 Ice Hound. I do want to quickly move across though to the maximum level, which is level 6. As with all of the super troops, the Ice Hound will mimic the level of your Lava Hound. When we look at the stats of the Ice Hound, we really don't need to take into account the DPS. We want to know hit points, spawned units, and troop capacity. So 10,000 hit points for the Ice Hound. When you compare that to the regular Lava Hound, it only has 8,000 hit points, but it does spawn 18 units. In comparison with the Ice Hound, you only get 12 spawned units and an increased housing space of 40. But as you will probably guess, due to the Ice Golem mechanics, the Ice Hound will have a freezing effect. 4.25 seconds when destroyed. This is huge, and it is the special ability Best Served Cold. Attacks from the Ice Hound and pups slow down their enemies, and upon defeat, the Ice Hound freezes its surroundings. So not only as the Ice Hound is attacking are you getting the freezing, you also get that freeze spell effect at the end. One thing I forgot to mention about the comparison as well is that the lava pups and the ice pups have the exact same stats, 35 DPS and 50 hit points. You get more of the lava pups, but the ice pups have the freezing effect, so I would argue that they are better. So the first thing I did was set up a bit of an experiment here on the developer build. Sent in a Lava Hound to an air defense and an Ice Hound to an air defense. It is 10 extra troop capacity, so is it worth it? You can see straight away that yes, the Ice Hound has greater hit points, but it is surviving so much longer because it is also slowing down the air defense with its freezing effect. So in my opinion, it is far superior for a Lava Loon attack to use the Ice Hound because you get the longer tanking and you get two distractions for your balloons. You have the freezing effect and the ice pups, whereas with a regular Lava Hound, you only have the pups to distract. What about versus 3 air defense then? So we can put the Ice Hound to the test. Obviously, it goes down way quicker, but take a look at the freezing effect. Exactly the same as a freeze spell or the freeze from the Ice Golem, and with the ice pups slowing down the air defense as well, they actually do pretty good, and I think this will be a buff to the Lava Loon attack strategy, and arguably we have already had that with the Log Launcher Siege Machine and the Invisibility spell, and I will link those videos down in the description. What about the Archer Queen? Could the Ice Hound and the ice pups actually take her down without a spell due to the freeze spell and the effect of the lava pups? I wanted to test this out straight away after I had read the initial description, and although they do pretty good, they just cannot get through the queen enough. They do take her down to about 50% health, so in combination with the headhunter, I think they would take her out. So I did want to quickly test with a rage spell just to make sure that the ice hound could take down the queen. This is a popular method, the queen pop method, where you use a lava hound and the pups to take down the queen, and both the lava hound and the ice hound were able to take the queen. What about on defense? Is the ice hound any good? Now I know what you're thinking. joking. This isn't the Ice Hound. I want to quickly explain because it is often asked, why do people use a Lava Hound? It can't take down the troops. There are two types of Clan Castle troops. A damage CC, such as this, where you try and take out the opponent's troops and or force them to use more spells. Then you have the type of CC that is purely used to slow your opponent down. That is why people use a Lava Hound. I am going to skip through this so we can get to the Ice Hound, but obviously I want to compare the Ice Hound to the Lava Hound, and it took 26 seconds from the Lava Hound coming out to going down, and that was with two poison. Now, when we compare with the Ice Hound, you would think that it would be better because of the freezing effect. But actually, what I found is as long as you poison the Ice Hound, it actually cannot freeze the queen very well, as you can see, because the poison not only deals damage, which is next to nothing on a hound, but it slows it down, which meant it really couldn't slow the queen down. And in effect, it was exactly the same. It was just about to click to 27 seconds. What about if you missed the poison? Or you accidentally lured the Clan Castle troops and you had no way to pull the Ice Hound to the other side of the base. You didn't have an archer, let's say. Well, you can see that the Ice Hound, without the slowing down from the poison, is able to slow the queen significantly. And it actually took more than 30 seconds for the queen to pop the hound, and that is without the ice pups then slowing her down further. If you have just found my channel through the sneak peeks, I like to bring educational but entertaining Clash of Clans videos. So if that's the type of content you want to see, I would recommend subscribing and turning on the notification bell. We are so close to 400,000 subscribers. Your support this week has been amazing, and I am trying to get there by Christmas. I want to use the practice mode to share my initial thoughts on the Ice Hound, and then I will show you a Lava Loon attack, because there is no doubt the Ice Hound is best used for a Lava Loon attack, but they can be used for other strategies such as dragons. I was trying them with E-drags, two Ice Hounds, 5 to 6 E-drags, getting a little bit of success, but they are base specific as well, as long as the Ice Hound is not going to get instantly shredded when you deploy it into the base. But that does raise an interesting point, because as part of this, you need to make sure that the Ice Hound is actually going to pop. Otherwise, you're not getting the full value. Let me explain. Even with a regular Lava Loon attack, you do want the Lava Hounds to pop so that the Lava Pups can help to clean up the base. But in this case, it's an extra 10 troop capacity, and actually, if you do not get the Ice Hounds to pop, you're not taking advantage of the freezing effect, you're not taking advantage of the Ice Pups, and ultimately, you are not getting the 10 extra housing space value. So you need to make sure that the Ice Hound does pop, so you're only going to take 1 to 2 of them for a Lava Loon attack. Probably 2 if you are doing just a Sui Lalo, which I think will be pretty good, and maybe even 1 if you are doing a Zap into Hero Dive Lalo, where you are literally taking out a huge portion of the base. Now, I will show you a Lava Loon attack, and I do think they will be superior. That's my opinion, but let me know yours in the comments. And if you are part of my YouTube membership program, be sure to use your custom Juno Sloth emotes. You guys have been using them all week. I love to see them. And if you do want to join my YouTube membership program for exclusive perks, you can hit the join button on my channel. I decided to use the Zap Hero Dive Lalo attack. Now, you do know that the lightning spells are changing. They no longer hit the Clan Castle. I mentioned that in sneak peek 1. I love my technique of using the Super Wizards with a Rage and an Invisibility spell. I showcased that to you yesterday in the Super Wizard Explained video, and if you do want to see that video, I will link it after this attack, because look at the damage they can do. Now, I am not a good Lava Loon attacker, so with the Ice Hound, as much as I try to bring you the best ways to use it, I am sure that Lava Loon pros will be able to demonstrate it better. But I've broke down the mechanics, showed you everything about it. Now let's continue this Lava Loon attack, and you will see how crushing it is. Because with the lightning spells, you can still get good value as long as you take out the queen and the eagle. I think are the best value. They are 7 lightning spells, with an Earthquake for the Eagle, and it now takes 6 for the Expo and the Scattershot. You can't take out the Clan Castle, but I do like my Super Wizard technique, then extending to the Hero Dive. I haven't started the Lava Loon, and we're 50% through the base. That's pretty incredible. So let's hone in on the Ice Hounds, because even if there are 0 air defense left, they still slow down the initial defense that is firing, and when they are popped, you still get the freezing effect. Look at that freeze. It froze the Archer Towers, the single target Infernos, then I have the Ice Pups to clean up as well. I did use my Grand Warden's ability to get my balloons to the Town Hall and then sacrifice them because I knew I had more than enough in this base, but I do think the Ice Hounds, as proven, are incredibly good for a Lava Loon because of the freezing effect. I think they're going to be the new way to Lalo. Remember, you can take 2 super troops now with the update. So you could take a Super Wall Breaker in order to set up your Hero Dive, zap one area of the base, then use the Ice Hounds for the rest. Interesting for sure. I do think they will be used probably a lot more than the Super Wizards, but if you do want to use the Super Wizards and you want to know about them, I have my video on them linked right here. I'm sure you will enjoy that one. Subscribe button is there as well, my friends. You take care, enjoy the rest of your day, and I will see you in the next video.